My name is Lauren. I'm a registered nurse and certified cardiac rehab professional. I work in cardiac rehab, where we help people with heart disease every day. We help people identify their risk factors for heart disease and help them figure out what to do to control them. The most common heart disease problem that we see is atherosclerosis. This is also known as hardening of the arteries. This is when fats build up in the walls of the arteries. This narrows them, makes them less flexible, and makes them prone to clogging. This can result in a heart attack or stroke. There are a lot of risk factors that can predispose a person to heart disease. Some are family history, smoking, extra weight, high blood pressure, high blood sugar, and our topic for today, which is high cholesterol. The good news is that high cholesterol can be controlled, often just with simple lifestyle changes and sometimes with medication. The first step in this process is getting your blood cholesterol checked. When you get this test done, it's known as a lipid profile. A lipid profile measures the fats in your blood, specifically cholesterol and triglycerides. So let's talk about cholesterol and triglycerides. Let's talk about what they are, what they do, and some actions you can take to improve them. Cholesterol is a waxy substance in your body. It is used to make cell membranes, to aid in digestion, and to make various vitamins and hormones in your body. Your liver makes all the cholesterol that you need. What can happen is when you eat too many saturated fats, your body makes extra cholesterol, and this gets deposited in the walls of your arteries, leading to heart disease. Cholesterol can't get around by itself. It needs a carrier to get it to and from the cells. There are products called lipoproteins that carry the cholesterol to and from the cells. There's the high-density lipoprotein that carries cholesterol, and this is known as your HDL. Then there's the low-density lipoprotein that carries cholesterol, and this is known as your LDL. HDL is your good cholesterol. It can help prevent heart attack and stroke. When you're thinking about HDLs, remember the H's. HDL is your happy cholesterol, your helpful cholesterol, and you want your number to be high. LDL is known as your bad cholesterol. We all need some, but too much can get deposited in your artery walls, clogging them. This increases your risk for heart disease. When you think about LDLs, think about the L's. L is for your lousy cholesterol, and you want your number to be low. The lower, the better. Triglycerides are a type of fat found in your blood. When you eat, your body converts calories that you don't need into triglycerides that are stored in your fat cells. When you eat more calories than you need, you can have a high triglyceride level. When you get the results of your lipid profile, you can see where your HDL, LDL, and triglyceride numbers fall in the reference range provided. Are they in the desirable range, borderline range, or high risk range? Let's talk about how to improve your numbers. If you smoke, stop. Research clearly shows that quitting smoking can improve your cholesterol numbers. Secondly, lose weight. Even losing 5 to 10% of your body weight can improve your numbers drastically. Get regular exercise. Aerobic exercise is best. Aerobic exercise is when you get your heart rate up. You don't need to punish yourself doing crazy things that you would never do. Walking is the best medicine. Start gradually and work up to 30 minutes a day. If you have limitations, don't despair. Just try to sit less and move more. Talk to your doctor. Maybe you need some physical therapy or cardiac rehab could help. The key thing to do if you want to lower your cholesterol numbers is to eat healthier. A healthy diet is way more important than focusing just on a single cholesterol number. Eat a variety of fruits and vegetables. The more, the better. And the more colorful, the better. To start, shoot for eating 4 to 6 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. This is doable. Don't feel overwhelmed. You don't have to eat a whole cabbage to make a serving. A half a cup of cooked vegetables, 1 cup of raw vegetables, or 1 medium fruit equals a serving. Get plenty of whole grains and whole grain foods. These foods contain a lot of fiber, which help keep you full longer and will definitely lower your cholesterol. For good sources of protein, eat fish, beans and legumes, and nuts and seeds. Limit red meats and fatty meats. Limit or eliminate soda if possible. Soda has no nutritional value, whether it's diet or regular. Drink water instead. Limit alcohol, as it does have a lot of sugar and calories. Alcohol has been shown to increase triglyceride levels. Overall, focus on a healthy eating pattern. The DASH diet is a good one to follow, and so is the Mediterranean diet. Eating more good foods can crowd out bad foods. So to sum it up, a healthier lifestyle is where it's at to decrease your cholesterol and improve your health. It's easy to get focused on numbers. Though a good starting point, they don't tell the whole story. It's important to discuss all your results and your risk factors with your healthcare provider, and then focus on things that you can change. Now is exactly the right time, the perfect time, to learn to eat less, eat smarter, move more, quit smoking, and keep that weight off.